Hello, everyone. It's the Stardock stream. Hooray! We are live again, finally. I'm Adam Biesner, as usual. Paul Boyer, he's the lead designer. He joins me. He's over there.
Hello.
We are finally showing off our ship designer, which is excellent. Hooray! It's also out now, so we're not so much giving a preview, unfortunately, as giving a hello. Whatever we want to call it. So
a demonstration.
There we go. So thankfully Paul's driving, because, and this is no knock against the Galactic Civilization's ship designer. I am terrible at ship designers. Paul was making fun of me before the stream. He's like, all you have to do is do this and this and this. And he hits like three buttons that he has a sweet ship. And I'm like, I can't do that.
Well, we're ironically, I'm actually in the process of redoing the user interface right now. So this is kind of a preview, because the whole screen is going to change by the next build, but not really functionality-wise. I mean, some functionality issues will be resolved, but mostly just trying to get a better experience. This interface that you're seeing now was based on like my original mock-ups from a year and a half ago, and we just kind of kept going in because we would update other screens. We never really updated these because they were kind of complicated. So we made it work. Now we're going to polish it up. So a lot of what you see today is going to change drastically, but the overall functionality should be the same. So do you want me to start?
I would love you to design a ship live on the stream.
Well, I can do that. But I mean, should I explain what I'm doing first?
Well, you can explain what you're doing as you're doing
it. Okay. All right. So what we have here is the shipyard, which is like in Galaxy of Two, will be where all of the ships. You know what? I should unlock. Wow, that's so much faster. And so all of the ships that you have will be listed here. And you can then use these ships to either upgrade them or use them to start new ships or just create a whole new one entirely. So I'm going to go ahead and start a new one entirely. And this is going to take us to design mode. And we're still going to have this in the new interface. I'm tweaking a couple things, like where these all these crazy toolbar icons are moving around and stuff. But essentially in design mode, you can pick, just like in Galaxy of Two, you can pick a hull. Kind of what we decided to do actually just yesterday. I'd been thinking about doing it for a long time, but we finally have committed, is we're going to get rid of the concept of templates. They'll just be hulls. So this list will be a lot longer in the future. There'll be a basic one, a little one, and then there'll be full on ships, and you'll be able to save those as templates. And then, so in the future, you can just come in here and go, oh, I want a tiny, oh, I love this one here, and bang. So that would be essentially the equivalent of doing this use design.
What the hell? Okay, so my people here are telling me that the stream is not loading for them, which is great.
So they can't see anything we're doing.
Well,
it's really impressive,
right? Like, I don't know, because everything looks okay on my end, but I'm not seeing it stream in the browser window. So that's fun. So I'm gonna restart this. This might actually be getting captured. I'm not really sure, but I'm gonna restart the stream. Okay, I think we're back on, theoretically. XSplit certainly thinks that we are, but XSplit thought that we were on before. So, good time. So Paul has continued to kind of put together his ship here. Oh my god, I've been looking at these other screens, and I look over, and Paul has a sweet ship.
Well, this is an existing ship.
Okay.
This is essentially what I was pointing out, in that you'll be able to grab an existing design and just tweak it. What we'll also be able to do, unlike in Galaxy of Two, you'll be able to take that existing ship or that hull, whatever, we'll probably just drop the name hull and just use template, and you'll be able to then tweak that. So you can, you know, I want this to be wider. I want this to be spinning around for some bizarre reason. So, you know, so you'll be able to do all kinds of stuff. All right. So now going back here, we'll just go ahead and do a new ship. You'll have, we'll start with a tiny hull. There'll be all the different hull sizes. There'll be a brick or a starter brick, and then there'll be simple hulls, and then there'll be full on ships. So I'm going to start with something super simple since he was pointing out that he couldn't figure it out. And so we'll just go here. Bang. Wing. Oops. And hit symmetry. Symmetry makes everything look better. So I'm going to make that a little smaller. And then here's all, I'll give us a little example of crazier symmetry. I can gonna rotate this up. One of the things that isn't in the alpha that I'm really excited about is we actually have gizmos. So you'll actually see, you'll be able to grab these and move them around. They're kind of buggy right now, and I didn't trust them enough to put them in the alpha. So anyways, I'm gonna do this, and then I'm gonna go ahead and oscillate this a little bit. Let's see. So there, I made a little birdie. And then like it's a little off center, so I can move this thing down a little. Oops.
You're getting a lot of love for symmetry in the chat, Paul. Very happy.
As somebody who has used the ship designer more than I thought I've. Oh, it's your mouse is something sticky weird. Anyways, so yeah, so symmetry is one of those things that is freaking awesome. I can also, here, I can go batshit crazy and do something like that. You can also mirror and flip these. So like say there's a part, in Galsif 2, we had to make sure all the parts were symmetrical in case you put them on a wing so they would look right. In Galsif 3, you can literally just take any crazy ass non-symmetrical piece. Let's see, let's find something crazy and non-symmetrical. Here, this is a perfect example, although it's a little big. I can take this, rotate it sideways, or I can even rotate it this way, and then just, oh, actually this won't work exactly as I'm thinking, but I can mirror them. I can mirror this way. So now it's flipped on axis, or it's, I might be going a little crazy here. There might be a, oh, it's, I'm flipping it sideways and it is symmetrical, so you can't tell. But anyways, yeah, so there's all kinds of fun stuff you can do with that. Like I said, there's a lot of features that we still haven't added. Like right now, I just have everything listed by the size. There will be actually filters for like descriptions, like we'll have like a wings thing and stuff like that. Now, all that said, we're still in design mode. So this is where the people who want to go crazy are. Now, if you want to just make a ship to play with, you can go in here and say, I'm going to grab a hyperdrive, put another hyperdrive here, put a sensor.
Got an interesting question out of the chat, Paul. Hamel Mac wants to know, any chance for an XYZ visual axis for those of us who are 3D impaired?
That is exactly what we were just talking about with the gizmos. There will be three dimensions, and they actually exist. There, even if you go into options, it says show gizmos, and it's disabled right now. So yes, those will all be there. And then I go back to design mode here and go, oh, you know what? I didn't put on a wing, and now I could put on my, let's put on a sexier wing. Oops. Oh, and one of the biggest problems that people are going to run into is exactly what I'm running into right now, is the hard points in the existing alpha. We tried to auto-generate them. It is not working out. We're not happy with that at all. So we are actually, and the artists are the least happy about it because they have to replace them. We're going to actually go through and manually place the hard points. And what we're going to do is actually just have a lot less. In Galsif 2, we had to have a bunch of them so that people could do cool stuff. But now that you'll be able to move things around in 3D, and you know, who cares? Where you put it down at the tip of the wing, oh, I want it a little further over. Oh, you know, I. And then another great example is now with symmetry, I do this, or I want to put something here. I don't have to worry about that it's the same location on both sides, because the symmetry just does that for me. Another great little thing you can do is we actually now have non-proportional sizing. So I can actually go into here and actually say, I just want this wing to be really thin and really fat for some reason.
Paragon Renegade was just asking about part sorting, because right now it's kind of all blasted in a big shotgun blast.
Yeah, that's what I was just saying. They'll be tagged. They'll be tagged. Now, it's still going to be a little bit of a mess because, it's, you know, what do you call them? We have like wing. Wing? No, so there's wings. We have wings, bulkheads, shells, engines, or drive systems or things like that. We will have some sorting. What the killer thing for that, for the people who want to spend a lot of time in the designer, will actually be that you can favorite things. You'll be able to click this, say favorite, and then that goes into this tab here, and you just have your 20 things that you like to use all the time. And now, oh crap, is it not in here? Let me, here. I'm on. I can actually now also do this. I can grab this and this, and I can group them. And now this behaves as if it's one thing. And then what you can actually do in the internal build that isn't in the alpha is you can export it, and that will turn it into a part, just like any other part. So if you have a certain wing you're making a Enterprise nacelle looking thing, you just want to make it once. You make that once, you can put it on all your ships. So that's going to be really awesome. You can actually see right now, these are actually just parts I made. This is actually made up of three little parts. This is made up of three little parts. This drive is made up of three little parts. Even this crazy eye, I guess I took that off. And these, whether we'll support animation is still up for debate, but these crazy ones that have animation are all just grouped parts that I saved. So
awesome.
You will, like, if you're a modder and you want to make all your lasers look completely different, you can just replace them. Bang, 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 bang. And then they'll look different. So
that's awesome. I want to get to a couple questions we had on the forums. Please keep playing with the design while we're doing this. Forums had some really great questions before we got the stream running here, because they had so much time to come up with them because we had to delay the stream,
yes.
which we apologize for, but we're glad that you're here now. So one of the really common ones we saw, as Peregrine 23 was one of the people who mentioned this, do you have any ideas to help make fewer iterations of ships make more sense? Like, nobody wants to go back in and have to redesign their ships every time they get, you know, a slightly better laser.
Yes.
Right. So what are we doing to kind of address that sort of tedium?
Well, what we can do, well, there's a couple solutions. Currently, the game itself will design iterative ships, and they will level up, and every time you unlock something, it'll level it up. What we can do is let you replace those ships and then let the AI iterate them for you if you want. I haven't really ironed that out, because I actually think people might be more bothered by it than you would expect. What we will probably do is try and make upgrading a lot easier. So lasers, you get plasma, you want to replace your lasers. We make it so you can just open it in upgrade mode and click and say upgrade to lasers, and it'll replace all the plasmas with lasers. But the problem is, and this is very indicative problem of all of Galciv, of all the ship design stuff, is like, well, what if you had researched miniaturization? Or what if this, maybe you can now fit three lasers. So that's at the point where, you know, the player will still have to go in there. But we'll try and make sure that that's as easy as possible. We have lots of ideas. Really, honestly, the ones that work, we haven't really decided what will work best. So we're working, it is a known issue.
Sure. So, not really sure why people are having trouble hearing me. It sounds like I'm coming through. It looks like I'm coming through just fine on my levels. So sorry about that. Parrot Math asks, and again, this is a question that a lot of people have asked. What about designing star bases?
Well, you will for okay. So you can design a star base just like you would a ship, and then mod it in. So modders will be able to change the star bases. The reason we don't currently have a Starbase design system is because there's not really good gameplay reason for it yet. It is, however, on my wish list for an expansion, and I have some good ideas that I think will be really cool. But none of them are done yet. If you want to mod the ships, though, you will be able to build them. They essentially create what's called an object graphics config. You go in to the thing and say, and we might even at some point make an interface for us. We could just go in and say, my culture base levels 1 through 5 looks like this, this, and this, and this. And then you can do all that same stuff.
Very cool. People are complaining, Paul, that you're not staying on the microphone, because these mics are so directional.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
That's okay. I just like to make fun of people for that, because it's hard to do when you're not used to being on the mic a lot, and especially when you're doing other things like playing with the ship designer.
I'm just used to everybody being able to hear me. I'm a very loud person.
So. I have no idea what he's talking about. This is actually another one that we've gotten a lot. Paramat just asked in the chat, can we get a blow the ship up button in the ship designer so you can see what happens when it blows up?
You know, I had not planned on that, but that is a really good idea. That is definitely a polish point, but I think it's a cool idea. We have all these crazy animations, and we're going to have, you'll be able to, like here, I have this tab here is going to be particles. So you'll be able to put some particles on. We'll have to, you know, that's one of those things we'll have to balance, because it could really become a performance issue. We have lots of ideas for stuff like that, little like preview modes and things like that. That's kind of waggy.
Another one we've got from a lot of people, this one from 11th Star. Will there be things like player icons, banners, logos that you can put on ships? People are basically asking about painting and custom textures.
Well, there will be. There will definitely be at least logos. We have some ideas for other things. Those, however, are more polish things, so they probably won't sneak in until where everything else is pretty solid. So...
let's see, what do we got? Nasty Tang, my favorite name on the forums. Blinking lights, I want blinking lights. Seriously, can they be added? It's cool to see a ship with a blinking light here and there. !
I think blinking lights are definitely something that could be done. Where to put them is really the question. You could actually do a blinking light right now just through the animation cycle, literally. Here, I don't have anything that's a light. But here, let's cheat something up here. Okay, so I don't know why that. Oh, I see. I thought we fixed that bug. Darn it! Come on. Anyways, that was embarrassing. Embarrassing.
Like I said, I would end up with something.
Well, no, I
mean
it just didn't stick where it was supposed to.
Ah.
But okay. So. I'm going to take this here, and, I'm getting the hole. You know, that's a problem. We got this sexy outlining thing, and because it outlines things on it, now I just thought about it. I think maybe the sensor is a little bit of an example of that. Yeah, and essentially, we can make it so that something has a black side and a light side, and you just spin it. Or we can make it so that you have a light and you pulse it down to like being tiny and then back up, tiny, back up, tiny, back up. That would also make it blink. We might add an animation for visibility or for alpha, and that would do that too. So there's a lot of stuff that we will be playing with. Another great thing, just a particle that's a blinking light would also give you that.
Sure.
So there's going to be a lot of ways to do these things. One of the problems with this thing is just controlling scope. It's very easy for to get out of hand.
Well, because everything, like if you're not a developer, maybe you don't think about this, but everything you put on the ship is a thing that needs to get rendered in the game, like when it's in the game world, right? When it's on the map, when it's, when it's in a combat viewer, when that goes
well, in. Well, yeah, that's the where the big... stop that. You know, that should clear when I check that. I'm going to... Okay, there we go. So the combat viewer is where those like fancier things will really show off.
I like that animation.
You can do some really crazy. Oh, actually, I have a great demo I should do, where you have. you can do all kinds of neat things with. So, like I said, you'll be able to get to blinking lights. I don't know if that's where I started with that conversation. What is crazy is with symmetry, like in this example. You'll just slap something on and all of a sudden it looks on purpose. You're like, oh yeah, I totally meant to do that. So,
I had an interesting question out of the chat. MP3us asks, are weapons going to turn and look around instead of being static? I always found it kind of weird that the laser shot backwards in combat when your ship passed the enemy ship.
You know, that's one of the things we all talk about and we all want and is kind of a pain and doesn't really give us much. So, the answer is maybe, but probably not. If we can find a way to, like here's a good example. So this is a laser here. In order for this thing, let's see, what is this? Anyways, it's a laser for now, it's a laser. For this thing to track, it kind of has to have a whole like gimbal bottom, you know, it's spinning around, shooting at people. What happens when I want to go up and down? Now it's clipping into the thing. It really limits where you could put the weapon and how the weapon interacts with the rest of the ship. So it's unlikely that we will be able to do that in a way that we're happy with. But we always play with it. We always play with it. But we have, it was one of the things, it's like, oh, what if we could do this? And then it's like, yeah, that introduces all these crazy problems. A lot of the ways to solve that is to be like Star Trek and essentially make like the beam weapons and stuff kind of omnidirectional looking,
right? Undo feature possible.
Undo feature is definitely possible and will be in, because Sarah actually already started it and just didn't it was not a high enough priority to get in because we had actual like, hey, this doesn't render type of things. Okay, I was going to clear this and do that crazy weird spinny thing.
You should totally do that.
So hypnotizing.
Yeah, it's worth mentioning that particles are going to add a lot of sort of depth to the finer points of ship customization when they go in. Particle effects are not something that's in there right now, but will definitely be in. You can, like Paul said, you can see the there's a tab for them in the UI.
Yeah. Well, the particles we're working on are also very intensive, so you kind of have to LOD them out. You can't. You just have to be careful with that. Wait a second, I want this. I'm trying to remember what I did when I did this weird thing that I did. Okay, so sorry.
Oh, we had a kind of a random question, not necessarily to do with the ship designer. A Empire's Star from the forum asks, will ships have ammo capacities or an amount that can be fired per round?
There is a cooldown time, which essentially is the equivalent of that type of thing. You don't actually have to store ammo, but essentially the cooldown is like this does 4 rounds per cycle. This does 1, and it's usually actually more along the lines of this takes 4 ticks to fire. This takes 1 tick to fire.
And sure.
So yeah. So that's how we kind of simulate that without adding the management of ammunition or anything.
Right. Yeah, we don't want to get down to that point, because honestly, and this has been brought up on the stream before, when you're at the point on a medium or larger map and you're fighting 10, 20 battles a turn, you know, because you're late in the game and you're in these big galaxy-spanning wars, I mean, you don't want to spend 20 minutes on a fight, right? So it's always a matter of... It gets down to the question of, like, how far are we abstracting things, right? Where are we on the scale of... you know, giant, huge space empire simulation versus, you know, something like a Star Citizen, which is more like dogfighting, right? We're definitely on the giant, huge space simulation
yes.
part or side of that, I guess. For those of us who don't code, how hard is it to render custom ships in gameplay? Asks Hamilmack.
Render custom ships.
I think he's asking how hard it is. I think hard to tell. How hard is it to render custom ships in gameplay? Like, how hard is it to take the ships out of the ship designer and get them into the game? I mean, it's all like the whole thing is kind of built that way, right?
The whole system is built around the custom ships. So, yeah, all of our ships are just custom ships. So, yeah, no. If once it's in the thing, we do have to do some crazy stuff. I'm trying to remember what my whole demo I was trying to do was.
We prepared really strenuously and meticulously for this.
Busy breaking the screen. Okay, so now you rotate on hardpoint.
Here's an interesting question. Unreal Ed wants to ask, will your ships ever be featured in other parts of the game besides combat and the overworld map, like in the back of negotiation screens or when there's a new tech researched? Which sounds really interesting.
I would say yes, probably not in like as detailed a way as we would want, but yes, for sure.
What are you building?
I'm trying to get this thing. This thing is supposed to be. Oh, it is. It is tracking it. Okay, there we go. Get back.
I don't even know how to react to this. It's kind
of
great, though.
Yeah, you can get some crazy. I was trying to. I had this one demo of, like, them doing this really weird ballet dance, oscillating around the map, and now I'm pretty sure I've just broken it. Whoa. Did I? Okay, I have no idea.
This demo has gone completely off the rails.
Okay, I think maybe it might be time to clear that. I have another good example of.
Of
something here.
We've got a couple times people have asked, and I've just ignored them in the chat because I'm a horrible mean moderator. What do we have a limit to objects or things or particles or what are kind of the upper bounds of what people can add into a ship?
When your game breaks, that's the limit.
For alpha, that is
well,
literally
currently,
the answer, I think,
currently isn't it? There really is no hard limit. Whether we will need such a thing is debatable. We really would like to not have to do that. One of the whole reasons we went to 64-bit was so that I'm trying to remember which axis I want here. Oh, not that one.
That's why we need to get those gizmos in there.
Yeah. I should have just had them enabled for this, just to taunt people.
I asked, and you said you wanted public branch for this.
The problem is I have actually on the main branch started completely redoing the screen. So.
Oh yeah, yeah.
So it would be bad if you. Did that. Is it? There we go.
Another question from 11th Star. What happens if somebody puts profanity/nudity/etc. on their ships and you see it in multiplayer? Because as we all know, as Paul, like one of the very first things that Paul said in
I would say nothing is at this point. I don't think we are going to police that any more than, I mean, we're going to have rating. Why can't
so like if you see somebody in something in the game, you can say like
we'll
hey,
have
this
moderation
or
yeah, we'll have moderation. Oh, I see what's going on.
This is a question I can handle.
I need my gizmos back.
You do need your gizmos back.
There we go. That was way too much work.
Here's a question I can take while Paul's building his thing. Will the game be using Mantle? No, this game is not using Mantle. Still, there's some confusion some places out there on the internet. There's another engine that Stardock is funding called the Nitrous Engine, which is being built by Oxide Games. There was a Star Swarm demo that's on Steam. It's free. It's a demo. You can download it now. It's super cool. Thousands of starships floating around in real time, and it's really neat. But Galsiv 3 was started well before. There's no way we could have put this out on the Nitrous Engine. It would have, I mean, we'd be looking at like this game is going to come out 3 years later than it would have, and that's
and Nitrous
not what we
is really optimized for a different experience,
right?
Now, that said, Galsiv 4 or something, you know, will probably be on something like that, assuming we we get that far.
A lot of questions. People come up came up in the chat again. How are you know? Are, is there going to be a sort of marketplace or a clearinghouse where people can share their ships and their designs and all that kind of stuff? And I mean, we have all this whole huge plan for the metaverse, which is a thing that was in Galsiv 2, but will also be in Galsiv 3 in an expanded form, and is going to be super cool. It's basically going to be a way that you can share things, and things that other people have made will pop up in your game, and all that kind of thing. So, yes, there will be a way for that to happen. No, we haven't nailed down how that's all going to work yet.
Well, it'll probably mostly work through this through Steam,
through the workshop.
Yes, yeah, the workshop. We're we don't need to reinvent the wheel, and so there's a very strong community. You know, that's better. I don't know what that is, but you know, what's funny is if you go It's gonna hit. Whoa. So yeah, it's kind of hypnotizing. All right. So stop. Oh, boom, it just blew all the wing. Okay, anyway, so yeah, so the ship design, what was I saying? Yes, we will have a sharing system where you will be able to go in and save up your ships, and that'll be moderated to some degree, so people put giant penis ships up. They'll at least have to disguise them as not penises. As far as like the logo technology and stuff, hopefully, I guess technically somebody could sneak on some vulgarity by creating a custom logo that is the F word or something. We'll have to watch for stuff like that. But yeah. And we actually, the goal is for this to not only share ships, but to be able to share custom races, to share custom fleet designs. Like you design this whole base set of ships and you want to use them and share them, you can do that. Races, custom races, all that stuff will be shared. To the utmost we can manage to pull it off.
Another thing that came up a lot, importing custom parts. I know that's part of the plan. It's not currently in the alpha.
If I remember correctly,
like people can literally go build their own parts and bring them into the game. That is a thing that we're doing.
We're going to support essentially FBX, and we'll
which
have
is
an
a
exporter.
File format.
Yeah, FBX, which can be exported from pretty much anything. You'll be able to export it into. We'll have actually a little importer. You'll just go in and say import piece. Pick the piece, it'll show up in the thing, you can say yes, that's what it's supposed to look like, and you save it, and it'll save it as a part.
Right.
That's best case scenario. Worst case scenario, there'll be a little tool you have to download, and then you'll be able to put them in. One of the things we're hoping though is that people won't feel the need to do that, because they'll be able to build their own parts out of other pieces. One of the other cool things is that we are doing is letting people see other races parts, so you can actually, oh hey, and look, the weapons are showing up here as just pieces. That's, oh, there's a bug. So I can go in here and go, I want, as a matter of fact, this is what got Adam in trouble, is he found the asteroids and went, oh, I want an asteroid ship, or I want,
that wasn't me,
that wasn't you,
no, I think that was Jameis.
Oh.
But it's awesome. The biggest wiggle. It's my favorite.
So you can, I wanted to put these iridium pieces. And one of the things you'll see that you notice that these iridium pieces now look Terran. Whoa. That's a new one.
Uh-oh.
I have to report that. I wonder what's up with that. Here, I'll get rid of that and see if that a general bug or is that...
I love the live debugging that we always end up doing on the stream.
So anyways, you can see this piece has the Terran colors, has the Terran subsurface, even though it's an iridium piece. So I can then actually go in and grab an Altarian piece, and same thing. Ooh! I think maybe I've created a monster here. It's
possible.
Let's clear this. So these are... Here, let me find a typical Terran piece. So here's your typical Terran piece, right? That is designed to look exactly like that. But I can then go down and grab, let's see, a Drengen piece. The Drengen ones actually tend to go really well with the Terrans because they're also very blocky. Here, let me get this. Terran. Here, so I can grab a Drengen piece and stick that behind it, and you'll see that it has the same subsurface, it has the same colors and everything. I can then go grab something really weird, grab an Altarian piece, which I must have passed.
Sorry, folks, I'm kind of fighting off a cold here.
Okay, and this is, they're designed to be very curvilinear and crazy and wacky, and this one is exported at the wrong angle, so that makes me angry. But but you can look at this and see same thing. So the beauty of this is, unlike in Gals of Two, where everything was baked in, this like subsurface texture, if I was an Altarian, if I was using an Altarian ship and doing Terran parts, they would have the little hexagonal subsurface and the different lighting and different material settings. So like if your Terran ships are really shiny and your and you can, or if your custom ships are really shiny, you can actually just add any part and it'll pick up those settings, pick up those lighting settings. It's very cool.
So basically the upshot is that it makes everything match a lot better, even though they were originally designed to be
different parts.
Right.
Yeah. One of the things that isn't working yet is you can see this subsurface, this tile pattern in here, right? Currently it scales with the texture, but that will in the future actually scale with the size of the ship. So you can then take a little part and scale it way up, and the subsurface will stay the same density, and it'll make that part look a lot cleaner regardless of its original like bitmap density. One of the things that isn't in right now is you can also change, we will have an advanced tab here where you can change the gradient maps used, you can change the colors, you can change the lighting settings, like how shiny it is, how opaque the subsurfaces are, how much bump the subsurface has, how much bump. So those are all very advanced things. We're still trying to filter out how much of that we want to expose to the player.
Very cool. Jacob asks, is it possible to build missiles like in Gals of 1 where a whole ship was a missile?
Sure. Why not? Yeah. Matter of fact, not only that, you can make your whole ship a missile, literally. So you can just save this as a part and then go in and replace the Sparrow. You might kill the game by having, you know, 400,000 polygon missiles. But yeah, you could do that. And so we have a lot of stuff planned for that.
Unreal asks, will you be able to type values for numbers instead of using sliders to be able to get in and fine tune things?
Yes. As a matter of fact, you should be able to do that already. It's a little buggy, but you should be able to do that already.
Nice.
I need to go back to just having my own parts. One of the things is like, you end up with a lot of parts when you do this. So, I can go in here and say, put this, whoa. See, that is a bug. Okay, anyways. So this, I can go in here and I can scale this and I say I want it to be 50. And it's 50.
Nice.
Or I can say I want this to be 90. One thing that I did ask for in the design doc that I don't think is in is you can't tab through them yet. So I would like to be able to just go tab 90, 90.
Oh,
90,
yeah.
Blah, blah, blah. Yep. That said, I'm hoping a lot of this stuff, the slider will always be here, but I'm hoping the gizmos will replace it and you won't even really feel the need. You'll literally just grab it and spin it to where you want it. And we will have different constraints. There's you can buy degrees. Right now I have everything at its lowest quality. Matter of fact, let's turn these over here. I'll go to, yes, I know that this looks bad. let's go 15 degrees. So now when I put on this wing, when I rotate it, it will snap in 15 degree increments. So you can actually, that's actually very useful for when you're trying to keep things super uniform. And
oh, sure.
Yeah. And if you're trying to design symmetrical things, one of the really cool things to do is essentially just take a, I don't know what a good sample here. Let's take this thing and do two of these. Rotate this. Yeah, and we're going to have the gizmo, so you'll be able to tell which direction you're spinning. And I kind of screwed myself by disabling that. But what's funny is in Galsif 2, you didn't have that. So it's not like you don't miss it till you till you've had it. And then you're like, oh my God, why didn't we do that? So, you know, you can just really quickly do.
That's cool.
Crazy geometric shapes, right? You know, so now I take this thing and I actually, oh, you know what's funny is this is mirrored. I'd have to group this to get it to right, but I wonder what happens if I live on tape. Okay.
Seriously, we should plan our break the game sessions differently than our stream the game sessions.
Okay, all right. So, yeah, so you can go a little bit crazy. Whoa. So, So you can do all kinds of wacky stuff with symmetry. It's one of these. This is, like I said, one of those questions where it's like, do we need the player to be able to do this easily? We have to make sure that we have to limit a little of those things so that the player doesn't literally break their ships, which is one of the reasons why undo is so important.
So we'll have that, we promise. Yeah. Awesome. Well, I think that's going to about do it for our ship designer, shipyard. I keep saying ship designer, and I want it to be the shipyard.
Well,
the ship designer is clunky.
The shipyard is the shipyard. The ship designer is where you design and update your ships. The shipyard lists the ships you have.
Yeah, but if you click on the shipyard button, it takes you to this screen.
Yes.
So.
To the actual shipyard. Shocking.
All right. Well, hey, thanks, everybody. Really great questions this week. Really appreciate it. Hopefully, we will be able to, you know, keep the stream up a little bit more consistently. I really apologize. This last whole couple weeks got a little bit crazy just because the dev team was trying to make sure that they could get this patch out to you first and get it out in the shape that we wanted it to be out. You know, it's we love doing the stream, but it's more important for us and certainly to the dev team to make sure that we're, you know, getting you guys in the game and getting that feedback that you guys can provide, because that's the whole point of doing this early access thing. So, hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for joining us. We should be back hopefully next week, talking about some more things, possibly doing some more ship designery things. We'll see. Anyway, that's it. Bye, everybody.
See ya.